got J Hawk Gaming. Let's get it.
She told me put my heart in the bag, and nobody gets hurt. Now I'm running from your love. I'm not fast, so I'm making it worse. Now I'm digging up a grave for my past. I'm a whole different person.
MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game one of the American League Division Series between the Aztecs and the New York Yankees. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, we'll start with you. This series has the feel of one that's about to get very interesting.
Looking at these two squads, it's clear both of them have several guys that can hurt you with a bat. It's not just the middle of the order guys that you have to look out for as a pitcher. So the team that gets the timely hitting and quality at bats is probably going to prevail.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next.
All right, here we go, getting into game one of this series. Second inning, Nick Banks, deep drive, left field, Stanton over his glove. Nick Banks, the captain, gives us an early 2-0 lead. Bottom six, we flash forward right here, and he walks Aaron Hicks and loses his perfect game, so he's still got the no-hitter going. Two out, seventh inning, fly ball. It has warning track power and just past the glove of Nick Banks. So there goes the no-hitters. 6 2/3 no-hit baseball. Top nine, Bo Naylor, deep drive, right field, well out of the ballpark. Solo home run gives us a 3-0 lead. Dewey's up, runner at first. Line drive into the left center field gap. The runner on his way home from first and will score easily to give us a 4-0 lead. Whitley looking to finish a complete game shutout right here. 1-1, ground ball. Third baseman, second baseman, first baseman. Double play ends game one of this series. We shut out the Yankees by a score of 4-0. Forrest Whitley put on a show. A three-hit shutout in this first postseason game. Banks, Naylor, each with home runs. And Whitley, as you see, three hits, two walks, nine strikeouts. Great outing from him to start this series as we get a 4-0 win on the road. And three hits for the Yankees. They just couldn't get their bats going here in game one. Somehow shut them down. Cole didn't pitch bad at all. Six innings, four hits, two runs, nine strikeouts. Just couldn't get the run support they needed. So now we get into game two of this best of five series. And line drive off the bat of Judge off the pitcher Keady. And they'll jump out early, 1-0 in the fourth. Bo Naylor leads off the top of the fifth. Deep drive, left field. If it stays fair, it's gone. And it does stay fair. It's a home run. And just like that, we respond to tie the game. Very next batter is Nick Banks, 2-2 count. There's a slider, hangs to the middle of the plate. Warning track power, it looks like. Aaron Judge cannot bring it in. Just somehow gets over his glove. Back-to-back home runs gives us a 2-1 lead. Flash forward to the seventh inning now, and Zambrano line drive into the gap. Hicks has a problem with it, but it's going to be an easy stand-up double to make this a 3-1 ball game. Here's Bo Naylor in the ninth with bases loaded. Deep drive into the gap. Easily going to score the runner from third. Easily going to score the runner from second. We're going to send Seth Beer from first to throw to the plate. Not in time. 6-1. Nick Banks up again. Deep drive. Left field. And over Stanton's glove. So he hits home runs over two of the tallest players in baseball. 8-1. Ground ball. Game, set, match. We have ourselves an impressive 2-0 series lead going back to Mexico City. We're getting ready to play our first home series, home playoff game. As you see, 8 runs, 13 hits. 5-for-5 is Bo Naylor with the 4 RBIs. Banks, 2 more home runs. He's already got 4 home runs this postseason. Urquidy, 8 innings, 5 hits, 1 run, 5 strikeouts. Strope finished it off. Yankees, their bats have been quiet this series. 5 hits today, 7 more strikeouts. They just can't get anything going. They need to get their bats woke up in a hurry, or right now they're in a spot where they're looking at a sweep. Severino did not pitch bad. Like, the starters aren't pitching bad for him. They just can't get nothing going on offense. Here we go. First home playoff game in our franchise's history. Zambrano with the deep drive, and it's going to drop into the gap. We're going to send the runner home from first, Newton. And a smart play on the base pass gives us a 1-0 lead. Still in the third right here, Jeremy Pena. Line drive, and it will get past Aaron Judge in right field. Zambrano on his way home from second. Pena the third, and we got ourselves an early 2-0 lead. Still in the third inning. Cespedes line drive over the head of the third baseman. Who's that, Urshela? I think so. Anyway, 3-0 lead. Top six, Bo Meyer pitching really good. Line drive in the left field. They're going to send the runner from second. Just throw it to the Kaufman, and makes this a 3-1 game. Ball eight, still 3-1. Patchy, deep drive, left field, off the wall. No, has enough to get over the wall. Home run, Christian Patchy. Gives us a 5-1 lead. Nick Banks up right here. There's a deep drive off his bat. And off the wall in left center field. Right center field, my bad. As we get ourselves an RBI triple and a 6-1 lead. Here we go, Booker. The announcer called this one.
Final out. Swing and he pops him up. Looks to be playable in foul ground. And that's it. They're headed for the ALCS.
We do it, guys. We have advanced the American League Championship Series with a 6-1 win. Yankees bats came to play with 10 hits today. Just, again, couldn't get no run support for their pitchers. Paxton, 5 hits, 3 runs, 4 strikeouts. I mean, their starters did not pitch bad this series. They just never could get the run support that they needed. As you see on our side, 6 runs, 9 hits. We had 3 triples. And Patchy's 2-run home run in the 8th inning helped us out. Mayer, 5 and a third, 8 hits, 1 run, 3 strikeouts, and then the bullpen the rest of the way only giving up 2 hits. So we do it. We advance to the ALCS, where we'll be playing either the Twins or Athletics. Here's what the playoff picture looks like right now. We're going to go ahead and sim a couple days, and now we got our matchup. We will play the Twins after they get by Oakland in 4. So now it's time to break down the playoffs and preview the Twins. Well, here's the updated playoff bracket. As you see, we sweep the top seed, the team with the best record in baseball, the Yankees, to move on to the American League Championship Series, where we'll take on the Minnesota Twins, who just defeated the Oakland Athletics in 4 games. So shout out to Oakland for a good season, winning our division. But Minnesota finally is moved on to the ALCS, where they get to play us in the National League side. It took the defending national champion Nationals 5 games, but they get past San Diego. Dodgers get by in 4 against Milwaukee to move on, so we get a rematch of the Nationals and Dodgers. Dodgers seeking revenge from getting beat in the wild card game last year against the Nationals. Let's go ahead and take a look at what's going on so far in the postseason. Bo Naylor leading the American League with a 6.11 batting average. Ian Happ for the Nationals is number 2 in the National League side. Will Smith is the leader for players remaining in the playoffs at 500. And then you got Trey Turner hitting 400. So we're just going to look at the top two teams left on both sides. As Naylor leads in postseason and hits with 11 of them. Jorge Polanco's got 8 for the Twins. Turner and Smith, 1 and 2 in the National League. We don't really focus on that bat. Naylor's got the most doubles with 6 of them. Triples, we have 3 as a team. And Castro's the only one in the National League left in the playoffs that has a triple. Banks leading playoffs with 4 home runs. And you got Cruz, Rosario, Sano, and our boy Bo Naylor up there with 2 home runs each. National League leader, Trey Turner. Yeah, there's going to be a bunch of them with 1. As Tatis hit 3 in that series against the Nationals. Sano leads in RBIs. I mean, top 4 right there, as you see. And then you got Justin Turner, 5, leading the way in the for the Nationals is Gurriel Jr. with 3 of them. Wow. Wow, you love to see it. Runs scored, stolen bases. Eaton's got 2 to lead the National League, and Zambrano's got 4 for us. Love to see it. Let's look at the pitchers. I know we're going to have pitchers in here. Nobody's got 2 wins at the pitcher yet. Nobody's got more losses. We got Trevor May has a save. Duffy has a save. Rich Hill, the starting pitcher, has a save. Did he pitch 6 innings out the bullpen? Oh, well, it shows regular season. Booker has a save. Doolittle and Jensen both with a save. Pagan ended up with 2 saves. Let's see, starting pitcher Whitley for us. A shutout in his first game. Urquidy, 1.13. Mayer, 1.69. Tully, a 2.57. But he pitched a wild card game, so looking like... and then Rich Hill's got a 3.0, but he has a save. And then next one, oh, geez. So their ERAs are kind of high. Their bullpen basically looks like they got them here. As you see, Alex Wood and Syndergaard are the first 2 to pop up for the Dodgers and Nationals. Home runs allowed. You're going to see a bunch of them with 0. Whitley, Syndergaard, and Strasburg each with shutouts. Whitley tied for first with 9 strikeouts. Did Nola have... Well, he started 2 games. He only started... Oh, wait, he started 2 games also. Did we have someone that didn't start 2 games up here? There's Price. He had 9. Whitley, Syndergaard, Strasburg complete games. Strasburg's pitched the most innings so far. Pitching war in the playoffs. Whitley and Syndergaard. Mayer. Bo Naylor and... Tatis and batting war looks good so far. How about postseason MVP? There's Bo Naylor, Eddie Rosario, Ian Happ up there, and then the National League, Will Smith, Trey Turner, Starlin Castro. You love to see it. So let's preview this Minnesota Twins team. Let's take a look at the calendar. It's been a while since we played them. We played them early in the year. And when was our first series? I think we played... Yeah, we went there first. I think. Jesus. Okay, we played them in our crib. Lost 2 of 3. Let's take a look at these box scores for these games. I like doing this better. But as you see, who gave us problems that series? Definitely Cruz, as you see. Well, Donaldson had a home run. They had a bunch of guys that hit the ball well in this game for them. For us... Like, look at this. Larkin's not even on the team anymore. He had 4 RBIs that game. Cumberland's not on the team. Diaz ain't on the team. Knoll's not on the team. Castro's not. Adam Castro. I wish he could have panned out, but we happily have a first baseman of the future. Rich Hill pitched that game and got roughed up at the beginning. But our bullpen kind of messed us up late in that game. Jesus. JoJo Romero pitched for us. Wow. Dino Salas struggled. Peter Lyon struggled. Yeah, our bullpen couldn't handle itself in game 1. Game 2, closer game, but they attacked us early. 16 hits total. Good God. Let's see. Naylor had a home run. Barrios pitched 6 innings, 5 hits, 1 run, 2 walks, 8 strikeouts. Yeah, they kept us in check that game. Tully pitched for us. Ooh, he got roughed up a little bit there. And then the final game we won. We came back in the eighth inning and won that game. Polanco, 4 RBIs out the leadoff spot. Let's see, for us, see, Dewey's had, we had a couple guys with multiple RBIs. I missed Crook. Hey, he got hurt. Dewey's had, a home run. Odorizzi actually got hurt in this outing. I remember that. Duffy got roughed up in that eighth inning. Ended up taking a loss. For us, Mayer pitched. He didn't pitch that bad. I mean, not that bad of a performance when we played them at our place. When did we go there? We went there for 3 games and lost 2 of 3 again. Won the first game in the series by a score of 10-2. And Bracho had 5 RBIs. I remember because Bracho hit 2 home runs. I was shocked by that. I was like, Bracho? For them, they scored 2 runs on 13 hits. Totally 8 innings, 13 hits, 2 runs, 3 strikeouts. Lions pitched a shutout 9th. We got the Medea. And, I mean, we attacked them all game, as you see. And then game 2 of the series, Minnesota basically jumped out 4-0. Well, 3-0 in the first, and that was the rest of the story. Just couldn't get nothing offensively going that game. I know we had 9 hits, but outside of that, like, the run support just didn't happen. Musgrove, that was actually one of his first starts with us. He went 6 innings, 7 hits, 4 runs, 4 strikeouts. Strope, one of his first appearances with us, 2 shutout innings with 5 strikeouts. Odorizzi, again, got hurt. So he got hurt in both of his starts against us. But Romero came in, pitched really good out the bullpen for them. Yeah, their bullpen shut the door on us, so. And then the last game of the series, we just got shut out. Offense didn't show up. I mean, we had 6 hits compared to their 7, but, I mean, we just couldn't get nothing going for us. As they had 3 solo home runs. Mayer got the loss again, so he's lost 2 outings against them. Reyes, 2 innings, 4 strikeouts. Butchery, 1 of his first starts. Smeltzer started for them, 6 innings, 3 hits. Hill pitched an inning at 3rd, 3 hits, and then, yeah, we just... So, it's, you can tell the pattern with them. It'd be like 1 game. Well, I can't even say 1 game because, But now it's a different story. We're a different team than we played them in August, as you see. Like, especially in September, because especially after losing 3 of 4 to Baltimore, did not look good for us. But, like I said, I wanted to take at least... split and then 2 of 3. Well, we got the 2 of 3 against Atlanta, but we took 3 of 4 in New York. And the rest of the story has been wrote. We have really dominated offensively, and our pitchers are doing its thing so far. As we go over here and, like, look at the team rankings, we got 2 of the top teams. Well, all 5 or 4 teams are in the top 5 in batting average. They're still in the playoffs. You got the top 2, basically. Look at runs. Wow. Yeah, Minnesota's, like, we held the Yankees to 2 runs. Compare it, right? The Yankees scored, it doesn't have any more. I swear they scored like 800 this season. And we held them to 2. 2. I'm not looking at player stats. I meant to go to team rankings again. Hits. We're leading in doubles. We're leading in triples. We're up there in home runs. Up there in RBIs. Up there in stolen bases. We've only been caught 1 time. That's beautiful. I mean, we're drawing walks. We're not striking out too much. I don't think we're striking out too much. At least. We got the top 2 slugging percentages. I mean, this is going to be a fun series. We too many double plays. We're working on it, though. We have the most errors. Most errors. Not good. Look at that. We have the top ERA. We're not even getting that. Like, it's under 1. Worth the Twins. 5.11. So, we really got a good shot. And then the Nationals and Dodgers. Oh, my God. That's going to be a great series to watch. I think we're in for a great series. We're not giving up that many hits, too. And literally, we've given up, like, 4 runs this whole playoffs. 4. Only 1 home run allowed. I think, yeah, that was in the wild card game. Only 3 walks. And we're striking out. Like, it's not high, but it's better than what I would normally think. So, this is going to be a fun series. Can't wait to get into this. By the time this video is posted, which is going to be well after Halloween, it's already going to be November. So, yay, we're in November. Hopefully Thanksgiving isn't canceled. But this video should be out November 2nd. So, hopefully we can get this. The playoffs are now best of 7 the rest of the way. So, hopefully we'll get this video posted by at least the 4th. Either the 4th or 5th of November. Either one. And then either a World Series or we'll be starting on the offseason. So, appreciate you guys supporting me. Next video is going to be Minnesota. Hopefully we can do our thing. Make your prediction below. Do I think we're going to get by Minnesota? I do. I'll give us 6 games. I'll actually give us 6 games this time. Because I said 5 against New York and you see what happened. I'll give us 6 against Minnesota. But you guys can comment your predictions below. Appreciate you guys' support, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. I can't breathe, I'm waiting for